What's up, y'all? Elijah from Okinama back with another Kendama unboxing. And today I got another Anma Kendama unboxing. These are the new updates from Anma Kendama. Really big congrats to them for fulfilling their Kickstarter and actually getting their goal. That's super awesome. Love seeing the community support each other. I hope I played a part in kind of, you know, contributing to that and stuff. They have really awesome products and all that. So I'm really happy for them. 3D printing, one of my favorite hobbies. Kendama, my number one hobby. So all of it coming together and them killing it is super awesome. These are the updates though. I've been in contact with the two people who own it and they sent me some updates of what they're gonna be doing going forward or some things they're gonna be trying and stuff. So let's get into it right now. Easy money. Okay, we got a bunch of new different things. Let's see what the tag says really quick. It says, hi Elijah. In this package are the most updated versions of our 3D printed Kens. Since the last package you received, the Serratos have been updated with unsmooth cups. Really cool. Higher strength and new string hole location for better pull-up stability. That's cool. The swords have been updated with a reinforced rod for strength and replaceable tips. Thanks again for taking interest in what we're doing. It means a lot. So thank you, Devin. Thank you, Nolan, founders of Anma Kendama. Really appreciate it. I'm really glad I could help out in any way possible. Anyone pushing Kendama is anyone I want to help. Whoa, bubble wrap. Give me a second, guys. There's a lot of stuff. Oh my God, there's a lot of stuff. Oh my goodness. I think that's it. That's all the goods. I think they sent me a whole nother set of everything. We'll just go over these one by one. Thing is super stuck together. That's okay. This is better than not packaging at all. We got that Rainer handle saw trainer back at it again, but with a little different stuff. So we still got the same threads and all that, which is really beautiful. Check out the threads. Some rattling going on. I think that's the core that's inside here. Oh. So I got my old one right here. And can you guys see the difference? Can you guys see the difference on this? And you guys see the difference? I have to tell you the differences because they're kind of minute. You see the tips right here? We got kind of an embossed thing, and then we got nothing right there. And that is because, again, like he said, we got the swappable tips with the metal core inside of it. So that should improve the durability. We'll kind of see. I've been kind of playing my normal one a lot, and I haven't found anything crazy yet, but this is 3D printed, right? So it's not perfect. Any kind of structural thing is gonna help a lot, especially with 3D printing, right? So there's literally just imagine a metal rod kind of down to here. And then another thing too, you see right here, we got the shininess in that cup right here. And now this cup is matted, right? So just to show you the texture differences, that you really can't hear anything. This, you can hear a lot more. It's not like crazy, but they didn't smooth out or acetone or I believe in the video I said epoxy. I think they're using acetone is what Nolan told me. They didn't do it on the cups. So now you're gonna get a lot more grip out of your cups, which is such a good move in my opinion. Let's actually do a quick comparison really quick. So I'm gonna pull up really quick on this. That's like, you know, fairly easy to balance right here. If we do the quick stop really quick, which I love of this system, I can get my old ones, put my new ones in just like that, which is super awesome. And if I pull up on this, it's gonna be just a lot more grippier. If I pull up on this, it's gonna be just a tad bit more grippier. That slight grippiness is just gonna give you a little bit more assist in the whole time playing this thing. Just seeing those minor updates on the cup and then on the tip is like actually so game changing. And I'm so excited for when the people who like supported the Kickstarter get their diamonds, they're getting this version, which is super cool. Let's continue the trend on what we actually just saw. I just pulled out my old one. So let's go look at the new version of what I just pulled out. Next up, we got the Swarada right here. This thing again is one of the coolest things. I didn't mention this in my original video, but the small cup spike thing kind of reminds me of that Paul Allen Weens, I think that's Jake Weens' dad. He did like some hand turned kendamas and he did the spike in the small cup, which is really cool. But again, with those updates, again, they acetone the cups here, made it really glossy and stuff. Here, it's just matte. Again, you're gonna get the same grip. Bring it back here. You can hear nothing happening right here. You can hear slightly more texture gripping, which is really cool. I like that idea. I really like it. The printers we're using are really, really good printers. So this is already like pretty smooth on the inside. You don't really need to acetone it. The acetone is more of a texture more than it actually helping anything. So really glad they're not doing that to the cups anymore. Stall points are still the same though. So again, no smoothness there. They didn't really need to do anything. But what I'm excited about is the new string hole placement. Yes, dude. So as you see right there, we've got a classic string hole setup right here, which is super duper awesome. They just raised it literally one of the notches because it used to be in the middle right here, kind of reminiscent of the tribute days and stuff, super duper kind of in the middle instead of being high up. But this one, way more cool. Pull-ups are gonna be way better. That just looks way more solid than before. So I'm just gonna, let's see really quick. Yeah, this is gonna pull up like a normal kendama now, which is really nice. I don't have a tom on it, Literally just me holding the string, it pulls up so much better now. It's actually insane. I'm really happy about that. So really nice update right here with the string hole. Super sick. Let's get another sword up in here, why don't we? So I think, again, this is gonna be the same kind of deal. We're gonna get to see the replaceable tips and stuff, but this is just the, I believe this is the classic, just a normal sword right here. Classic sword right here. I'm super excited to go over the swappable tips with you guys. But yeah, check that out. Again, we got the metal core, then we got the swappable tips right there. Same thing, we got the nice smooth cups. Doesn't look like they changed anything with the sword shape at all. So again, we got that kind of skinnier slip stop area. All the shapes are the same. It's literally just those two differences on the swords right now. One thing I did notice though, is that they have two different tip textures, right? So this one, this first one, this one has the acetone on it, and then this one does not have the acetone on it. You can't really tell on camera. This one has that, not rough, but that 3D printed texture that isn't a lot. The layer lines are nice and on top of each other, not really rough. This has the smooth kind of like glass-like feeling you feel. I think this is just a normal Serato right here, which is exciting. All right, cool. So we got a classic Serato right here. Again, same thing, matte cup. We're not doing the acetone cups no more, which is really, really great. Again, you probably can't see it well on camera, but we got the nice normal string hole. It's gonna be way better for quality of life and just overall playability experience. Last but not least, these are my favorite cups. Kind of. No, these things are so hard to play with, dog. And last but not least, my favorite, the challenge cups. They're just super hard to play with, dude. They're super hard to play with. But again, to confirm, I mean, that's way better. Super happy about that. Last but not least, this is actually something I feel like I had a little bit of influence on this. I've kind of talked to Nolan about some of the design stuff. Swappable tips with different materials is kind of what I've been talking about. We got different material on these kendama tips right here. So just so you can see right here, the way this works is that it's not threading into plastic, which is one of the number one worries with 3D printing. Instead, it's threading into this heatset insert. So basically, an insert is getting pushed into the plastic and melting around the plastic, basically is what's happening. So you get this really, really just cool, awesome thing right here. And that's what allows for these swappable tips. If you're kind of worried about, you know, it coming off, and I'll kind of test this too, seems pretty secure, but putting on like Loctite would probably kind of help it too if you end up getting loose ones. But that's a super cool thing. If your tip wears down at all, this is ABS, so I don't really expect it to, but if your tip does run out, you can get another tip of a different texture, right? So this one's actually just the ABS, and kind of like I was talking about without the acetone, so it's not smooth. You can quick swap them really super easy, just like that, which is super great, right? One of the cool things too is that you can now use different materials with this tip swapping. So these two right here that I have in my hand, they're the same color, so you can't really tell, but they're a softer material called TPU. With that, this tip actually has a different shape to it. Imagine the things you can do with that kind of tip. That's literally tightrope central right there. So if you land it perfectly, it's gonna land in that notch. And because of how soft this plastic is, it's not how hard and dense the ABS is. It's way more softer and a little bit grippy too. So this right here is a possibility now. 3D printed kendama that can do border bounces. Oh, I can hold it for a second. I'm gonna land a trick with that with the border bounces. But you see that? Yeah, that rubber tip is gonna make borders possible with the 3D printed Ken, which I love so much. They also did the TPU soft tip in the normal design, which is really, really cool. So this probably will last longer than the ABS. It'll kind of feel different when you're spiking it, but kind of like a bouncy thing. So maybe try spike taps with it. Maybe it'll be a bit more bouncy for that. There's just so many different possibilities with these kendamas, which I really like. The playability feature is there, and it's not just a gimmick. They all work towards playing and doing a really creative thing. It's really, really awesome. Once again, I am super stoked to be helping Ama Kendama out. These Kens are one of my favorites and one of the most fun things to play. Really excited for you guys to try these. If you signed up for the Kickstarter and all that stuff, super excited for you guys to get your Ken, be a part of the Ama Kendama 3D printed squad. These things are sick. These things are dope. If you guys enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, subscribe button, hit post notifications so you can be one of the first to watch these videos when they come out. And obviously sharing the video goes a long way for the channel. This is the live from Ama Kendama, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.